And I'm like, yeah, man, I read for that part. They gave it to the other curly hair nigga. And he was so Pac heard it.
You were supposed to be Raheem? What you remember about Big?
Man, Big was cool as hell, man. Big was cool as hell, always chopping it up, cutting it up.
I don't have no talent at all rapping. What if I wanted you to jump on the track on my shit? Is there anything inside the Kickstarter where you will do a feature with me?
Well, that's outside of Kickstarter, because at the same time, like, if you ain't got no talent, I gotta vouch that I'm getting on something that's legible. I mean, you have to have some sort of skill level for me to feature with you. It's not just about a couple of dollars. You gotta have some level of skill.
Some level? Okay. Yeah. 20 grand. I want you to be
all
in the
right,
video.
Where we on?
It don't even fucking matter.
Holla at your boy.
You gonna do your part, huh?
We gonna get it on. Matter of fact, you sit down. I'm gonna do the song. You just jump up in the video. Yo, what's up, y'all? It's your boy Special Ed, aka the youngest in charge, aka the magnificent, aka Crooklyn's finest. And right now, y'all tune into Thisis50.com.
I got it made too. Now you come from the, some people would call you a pioneer.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? There's somebody that started this shit. Does it concern you or how easy it is to get on now? Because when you was coming up, niggas had to be good for real.
Right. You had to have some skills.
You had to have some skills. And it don't really take all that right now.
Well, to me, man, it's a good and a bad to it. The good part is that any artist can be able to reach out to the whole world through the internet. You know, there's digital sales, which are taking over the majority of the sales in the industry. So that's the good part. You have a much better chance at success if you are to be successful. Now, on the other hand, now it's saturated because anybody with a cell phone or a laptop is like an overnight star. You know, you don't even have to have talent. And you can be successful
getting
paper just by your followers, the amount of followers or social media presence that you have. So it's saturated in a way which doesn't give a fair chance for the handful with the true talent, but it just got to shine through. You just got to be persistent, you know what
right.
I mean?
Right. Yeah. So, and the one thing that's dope about it too is seeing somebody that's blowing up overnight. People that do have skill, you don't have any excuse not to be successful.
Right, right.
I don't feel sorry for you, none of that shit. No, you can't say nobody's giving you a shot. Cause right now it's open for the people to see you you apply yourself and put yourself out there.
Exactly, which is one of the reasons I decided to go independent. You know, I've been in the game over 20 years and now for me, where it's at technologically and every other way, I feel like me putting my foot out forward independent is going to be the best way to reach my fans directly. So I just launched a Kickstarter for my new album. I got an album coming up this fall. It's called The Return of King Edward. It's at kickstarter.com/project/specialedmusic. I'm into cash in all ways, got dollars in my pocket. Cause man, it pays to be smart. I turn my art into an empire. Cause I grow and grow. So, you know, I never tire. Got the status and the clout, no doubt, of all time. I got the rhyme to take you out. Cause my rap is like a trap that you fall into. I'm special at. Now, who the hell are you? Yeah, man, I remember when you was JT Freeze on the Cosby Show, man. Yeah, Cosby Show, man.
What was that like, dog?
Well, for me, it was a new experience. You know, I never really done too much TV or anything. And just in that time, in that era, with the Cosby Show being so big.
Would you say that was one of the highlights of your life, man?
Oh, yeah. That's a part of history because no rap artist has been on the Cosby Show. And the Cosby Show is a historic earmark for our people, our culture, you know, in general. Even just for that generation, no matter what your culture, Cosby Show was a big part of it.
Mm.
Yeah.
I was in special ed, like all the way through school.
Right.
And when I found out that your name was special ed.
Right.
It made me, I thought you was like me, so it made it make me feel bad.
Right. Well, that's part of what the whole thing was. My thing was to dead the whole misconception
about
special
stigma.
Ed, period. Right. Mm. Even though it was a stigma, I still took the name with pride. Not just because my name is Ed, because I'm out there wild like what, But you're gonna understand we're very intelligent. We have a lot to say. We have a lot to offer to the world. Not being a special ed student, but being one that represents the name and knowing what the name represents. I had special ed kids all throughout school, in all my schools, so I know what the name meant, but I took it proudly and wore it, knowing that it would dispel some of the misconceptions of not just special ed kids, but urban and inner city and underserved youth. You know what I mean? So it was a whole, you know, mission to that.
Word.
Yeah.
Man, I really appreciate this, dog.
Yeah, no doubt. And just don't forget, I got the new album coming. It's called The Return of King Edward. It's coming this fall. So I want y'all to go check it out. Be a part of the project. Go to my Kickstarter, kickstarter.com/project/special ed. Or just go to Kickstarter and put in special ed and back the project, man. Be a part of the project. Come on stage, get featured on a song with us. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be the trio.
Come on,
you know what
man.
I'm saying? We're going to do what we're going to do. But trust me, it's going to be real hip hop, real music. I'm not catering to no particular audience. I'm not trying to sound like anybody. I'm trying to do me. I'm trying to sound like me, and y'all going to know exactly what it is.
Word. Well, like I always say, man, you just can't say you're real. It's something you got to be, man. Special right. Ed. We over when we out of here. Hey, do I have something in mind? Y'all go to commercial. Don't kiss them hoes in the mouth unless you got to.